Mr. Mark Jones. All right, good evening, everyone, and welcome to our pageant for 1993. And back again tonight, we were here last night for the talent contest, and boy, that was a lot of fun. I hope some of you had a chance to come out for that. We had a really good time out here last night. And we've got a lot of talented young kids here tonight. They're going to be vying for some titles and for Snowflake Day, so wish them all the best of luck. The first thing that we would like to do tonight is to introduce to you our visiting dignitaries for Snowflake Day. So if we could have them come on out here.
Contestants for the Miss Coon Rapids Scholarship program, which will be competing next Saturday and Sunday at Lane Senior High School, and here they are.
Competition this year, ladies and gentlemen, once again, that was Rebecca Kay, Miss Coon Rapids, along with our dignitaries from Coon Rapids Snowflake Days tonight, Eric Olson and Carolyn Voss. Definitely all. Nobody else? Okay, I think we got it. All right. Well, we couldn't have a contest like this, of course, without judges, and it's time now to get to our introduction of those fine folks, and we'll start that off with our judges panel coordinator this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Joe Zanotti. John Recker. The Reverend John Recker has lived in Coon Rapids for 25 years. He is married, and his wife Dora is employed at Minoka Ramsey Community College. They have four children, all grown, and all graduates of Coon Rapids Senior High. John currently is the priest at St. Paul's Episcopal Church on Lake of the Isles, and his interests include travel, gardening, computers, and rubber stamps. Okay? I had to make sure that's what that said. Okay. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the Reverend John Recker.
Definitely just have to go ahead and act these all out for the folks.
All right. Well, I'm a little bummed out. All the Miss Coon Rapids candidates left the backstage area. I don't know what I'm supposed to do back there, but. All right. It's going to be another one of those nights. All right. Let's see. Where are we at? All right. I guess it's time now just to dive right into our first category this evening, and that would be the junior category for modeling and escorting, as well as the speech competition. And that is for the juniors. Okay, here we go. I think I'm all wrapped up in a nice one here. I don't even have to think, which is a good thing. Okay. For our junior category for modeling tonight, our first junior contestant number one is Miss Sarah Ann Hopp. Plus, she said, Beanie Weenie. David Hughes. And let's keep him away from the gal contestants back there, okay? Deb Foster, Carp Fest volunteer. And I can't believe people up here don't eat carp to begin with, you know. I mean, that's fantastic fish. If there's few people that go catch these, this Carp Fest, don't want them, just dump them on my front lawn, and I'll go get them. Yeah, right, like you're really going to find my address. I have nothing to worry about. All right. Are we ready yet back there? I guess so. All right. Onward and upward. Our next category is the teenage. Is that right? No, that's that comes later. Junior. Organization is the key here. All right, our junior talent category. And Sarah Hopps is junior contestant number one. Sarah has vacationed in the state of California. And we have a different crew tonight working on our props. We had He-Man and Skeletor here last night. All right. See some more of tomorrow's events in Snowflake Days from 1 to 4 p.m. at Crooked Lake Beach. We'll have that annual fishing contest, and the Coon Rapids Rotary Club sponsors a wonderful annual pancake breakfast at Epiphany Catholic Church on Hanson Boulevard from 8 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. So for the best hotcakes around, they welcome you to the Rotary Breakfast, and that's tomorrow for Snowflake Day. Is this going to get dangerous here? Should I ask the front row to move back? It just does that whenever it wants to. I have no control. Okay, junior contestant number four. Well, maybe we should wait a second here. The next one just might not be a gymnast. Junior contestant number four is Laura Foster. And as I said before in her introduction thing, she thought that it would be, I wanted to see if Disneyland was as much fun as it appears in your dreams. Well, Audrey, you've got to win the Super Bowl first before you can go to Disneyland. All right. Somebody said that there was a certain letter here that I had to be sure and get to here if I can find it. It'll be the last one. It isn't even in here. Okay, well, we won't get to that then. All right. It's time now for our two junior Commodore. Well, I thought they were done. They must have had a break. Yeah, well, wait till he starts talking, then kick in the music again. All right. Are you done? All right, time now for our teenage rabbit and modeling competition and speech competition for this evening. Teenage contestant number one has been, every one of them, they asked who their favorite country western singer was, and not one of them so far has said Mark Jones. I just don't understand. You know, you drop out for a few years and they forget you. It's unbelievable. You know, our theme for this evening is the country western type thing, and you don't see as many western movies anymore as what you used to see. I know the past year Clint Eastwood had one that he did, and other than that, the only real big country-type movie in the last few years was Dances with Wolves with Kevin Costner, and I understand that production has begun now for the sequel to Dances with Wolves, and that's called Polkas with Porcupines, and that'll be out sometime in 94. So. There were a lot of delays in production, and Kevin was quoted as saying things have gotten a little sticky, so I don't know about that one. Okay. Teenage contestant number four is Miss Andrea Mae Brazel. You want another letter? No? Give me a guitar. It's been a few years, but I think I can still do it. Maybe we should have some of those for sale. What do you think? Heard they're giving them away now. They can't sell them, but nobody wants them. They're giving them away. They make great doorstops and paperweights, so people are kind of starting to look right. Okay, TH contestant number 5 is Miss Mindy Sue Foster. Boy, you know, during the intermission, I had the chance to walk down some of the halls and stuff around here at this school. What a beautiful facility it is here, Coon Rapids Senior. I know a few of you out there, though, are thinking, now, wait a minute. He used to live in Coon. He went to school here. That's true. I did. I guess I should have shown up more often. Teenage contestant number 6 is Miss Amy Lynn Ammonruth. Well, how about another letter? Maybe I'll just have a simple one. Coke, the choice of the older generation. All right. Teenage contestant number 7 is Miss Donita Marie Roche.
Gretch.
Okay, Gretch.
Speech communication, and
she will be giving up the Miss Coon Rapids title February 14th, next weekend. And she will be, says here, competes for Miss Minnesota in June of 93. So we wish her the best of luck at that time. So once again, Miss Coon Rapids 1992, the third for the Rapids Village.
Each winner will get a trophy, and then a grand prize winner is picked from those two, and that person, I have to look at here now, gets a free 11 by 14 photo sitting from Holzer Photography, given to us by Leo Holzer. And
nice. This is Greg's new truck. Well, how many days have you had it now? Got it yesterday.
Got a lot of metal flaking, and it's just getting dark. You can't tell. It starts getting pretty dark.
Not with this camera, it don't. Well, we'll go around the other side and look inside there.
Put a tinted rear window in that slides so you can open it up.
Yeah. Easter 1993, and this is what the bunny brought for me. Hey, that rhymes. Look at that. And Simon and Garfunkel's. And look at all that candy. There's George of the Jungle. And some new thing. We haven't eaten that yet. We don't know what that is, but it looks pretty good. And there's
what?
That big egg with my name on it. And there's all the candy. You got Pop Rocks and bubble gum and some chocolate coins, all kinds of stuff. All my favorite candies. And there's the babies. Hey guys, you got anything to say for the people watching? Happy Easter. And there's Hun Buns. We're back to the camera.
Don't do that.
We continue with Easter. Up in the kitchen. And we got more things. This is a little thing that we're taking over to Mom and Dad's to give to Amber. And here we have an Easter basket for staff we put together with the ugly duck in it. And a cute thing.
And candy.
Yeah, got some candy in there. And here now we have what the bunny left for Hun Buns. And she hasn't gotten a chance to tear into that yet. So maybe we'll have her do that right now.
That's not fair, looking the way I do.
Come on, who's gonna ever see this but us?
You show people.
Well, I got it down so your head ain't even in it. Ugly duck. Whoop, there's your head. And what's that?
You said this wasn't any good.
I didn't think it was, and then I went and looked, and it was pretty good, so I thought, well, I'll get it for her.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. It's got a couple of them on there.
Yeah, it does. Thank you. I love it.
Mm-hmm. It's a Prince CD that we're talking about, for those of you that... There we go. It's one of his first CDs. He's got the little Corvette, I think, is on there, in 1999. And I don't know if it was Delirious on it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's three hits then on there. Okay, and then we got some, I think there's some Yum Yums in there too, I think. Let's see what we got. Sorry about the basket being kind of crappy.
Got ears, eggs, and more eggs.
Yeah. Just the ears. That's a new thing that's out this year. It's just the ears of the bunny. Okay, and there's that. That's also from the bunny, but he brought that a few days ago for Han Buns. That was the what do you call that, lily?
Oh, the Easter lily, yes.
Yeah. And happy Easter from the babies, too. Look at that, that's baby girl, and there's Mo. There's Mo. Hey, well, Mo. Hey, Mo. Yeah, there's Mo.
Say hi to ugly duckling. Say hi to
babies. See, we have not filmed our babies for a while, so it's good to get them on the camera just a little bit.
They've gotten bigger since last time.
Oh, yeah. There's Iggy. Oh, Jesus! I gotta keep her away when I got the cords here. Shit. You get out of here!
Well, I think that's enough
going. Yeah, that's probably enough. Little Mo scared to death. He won't come out from back there. Little Mo! There he comes. There's Mo. He's a good boy. Yeah. He squeaks too. No, on his one fin there or whatever.
He came in so fast.
Yeah, there's a little tag by right by it. You have to.
My ears. Just the ears.
Just the ears. I've never seen anything like that.
Huh.
I don't hear so well anymore.
No, I just thought it was kind of cute.
Some of those.
Yeah. Your dad. Oh, it's a joke.
What's the first part of a chocolate rabbit everyone eats?
The ears. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I eat the tail too.
Yeah. And usually the
chicken
feet.
Freckled eggs?
Oh, those ones are
freckled. Are those like jelly beans?
Yeah, pretty much.
Kind of like.
I haven't had any of these ever.
Oh, they're delicious. They got cream filling in them and stuff.
Really?
They're really good, yeah.
Sandy brought one.
Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that cute?
Someday maybe I'll turn into a swan. We'll wait together for our time.
And then what? Mom got a. Where's her flowers at?
My flowers.
Are Dad got a CD and.
I wanted her.
Thank you. Look at what the bunny rabbit gave me.
You're not going to play that now, are you?
You see, I got it. Yeah.
There's my Glenn Miller CD.
Yeah.
Look at that. Isn't
that neat?
Listen.
Oh, I was waving at myself. I can see myself in the mirror. And this is our neighborhood. See the cul-de-sac we live on here? And there is our house. Here is our front yard. That's it. Okay, not much to the front yard here. This is our house, and the sun is playing all kinds of havoc with the camera here. This is our front door. Here is our backyard. You can see the grass line there. That's the property divide. Takes about 15 minutes to mow this baby. Get up on the porch. I thought I'd show you our backyard area. There's our deck. And of course the neighbor attached to us there. So now let's go up on the deck and take a peek. And here is our back deck. And there you can see the railroad tracks a lot better that run right along the property line there. The deck takes up about a fourth of the yard. Now, and let's see here now, we'll head into the garage and take a tour of the inside of the house. Now, as you can see, we got kind of a mess right there, but that'll be gone in a couple of days. It's the last of our moving trash. We got our snowblower and our new lawnmower there. And best of all, it's a Murray. And our cupboard space and our new grill, what we've had for a while, but we just had to put together here about a week ago, so we're going to start using that now. And that's the garage. So let's head on into the house and take a tour of the new Jones residence. There's our entryway. I wish this camera had a wide angle thing, huh? Because you can't really see too much. We're in kind of tight here, but anyway. And here we have the kitchenette, a little closet right here heading up to it. We have the kitchen. Donuts. Oh wow, who's that good, dude? And the dogs, who are not real happy right now, they're locked in their kennel. Okay, and now, well, this thing's having all kinds of trouble focusing today. I don't quite understand this. Might work a little bit better here. Okay, we're up in the front room here now, right off of the kitchen. That's where we were. And here we have our front room area. And of course, the deck that we came up on here. So let's take a peek at that ledge right there. We have plants up there now, but eventually we're going to have a big ceramic dragon up there. Be kind of neat. That's where we came in at, right down there and up those stairs. Okay, and now we're going to go back and see the rooms back here. See, first of all, we have the Johnny, of course. Bathroom number one. This is the upstairs bath. Oh, shut up. That's enough. There's our bathroom. Okay, and this other room here is Jan's craft room, and that's kind of an enter-at-your-own-risk type thing because it still is not cleaned up, so we haven't gotten to that one yet, so we'll let that go. It's just like a bedroom extension. There we have the babies. And they're not too thrilled. We used to let them, the first couple weeks we moved in here, we tried letting them, shutting them in this room and letting them have the whole room all day, but then they kept going poop in the bedroom, and we couldn't have that, so now they have to be in their kennel again all day long. This is kind of a neat feature here for the bedroom. We have the ceiling fan. It's kind of nice. Kind of a nice thing. Let's turn on a light here. And of course there we have the walkout to the deck where we just were a minute ago. And you can see the walkout to the deck. Kind of nice. This room is a bit dirty yet too, but I didn't want to wait any longer here to get this video off to you. So that's the upstairs. I suppose it would help to shut the light off, huh? Okay, now we'll go down to my area. The downstairs. And we'll check that out. And I think you'll get a kick out of this area down here because this is why I fixed this up. First of all, on the left here, right away, we have a storage area. But we won't go in there. It's just boxes and stuff. And then here we have our laundry room. You can see there. We got to get the dryer over here yet. That's still at the other house. But other than that, it's nice and cozy. Enough of that. And now we are about to enter the Auto Racing Hall of Fame here. My area, which I have fixed up. First we'll take a kind of a wide pan angle view of the whole room here. And we can see how this is all fixed up. And then we'll zoom in on certain things and we'll take a look at all that stuff. So we'll start over here. Of course, we have the Tomcat Carson shirt, and then have the. See if we can get a better focus on that. Steak and Shake mug there. And then some movies. A few movies there and there. And then, of course, I have my refrigerator with my Budweiser's and Coke's in there. And we have another t-shirt, the old Flying Deuce. And then we have more movies and Budweiser vases. And here we have a Southwestern Auto Racing Association's official shirt. And we have some old photos up there on the wall. By golly, it looks like the Petker painting number 11 in that one. Look at that. And there's, of course, Gene Dye and Goodall and Koppel and Gene Dye again. And this focus is off again. And there we go. Koppel again. Kyle Sellers there. There's another Koppel. And then we have some more shirts. Allied Auto Racing Association, and we got more videos. We've got the rack with books and albums, what few albums and 45s I still have left. And we got the Gravedigger. Let's try this thing back on auto again. I don't know. It might work a little bit better. I suppose we could use a few more lights in here. There's one of my old trophies, and trophy that was given to me by a race driver, and there's that trophy that Sensel gave to me, Cletus. There's another one of mine. And we got more shirts here. Cedar Lake Speedway and Gravedigger, and lights on down here so we could see a little bit better. Koppel and Goodall. Laverne Pryor. There's Ken Schrader from his years of running around St. Louis. That's an old shot. And here we have a picture of some handsome dude getting an award there. A picture of somebody getting an award. Taking a picture of somebody receiving a picture is what I was trying to say. There we go. There's an old Highland Speedway t-shirt and Budweiser clock. And here we have more. There's another shot of that Schrader car that Schrader autographed for me. And there we have Rusty Wallace in one of his first cars. And there's, of course, Dennis. The only year he did not drive number two. And there's Koppel again. And Sellers again. And now we'll pan back out. And there's another Highland Speedway shirt. And we got some knickknacks. There we have a Flying Deuce can cooler. A must for any true race fan. And here we have a couple of mugs and CD box sets, and then of course the CD collection, which is rather extensive. There's some more in there. Goes all along here and back in there. Yeah, it's quite just a few CDs. What's this here? We have a Highland, Illinois mug. But as you can see, just a little bit of everything here in this room. All kinds of shirts and paraphernalia and photos of different favorite race cars of mine throughout the years. And we have some hats. There's one. I'm sure, Kevin, I'm trying to get one of them for you, too, so you can enjoy one. So, in fact, this here Southwestern shirt was also, or I mean hat, was also autographed by Ken Schrader. So that was kind of neat. Let's see here. What else have we got? We got some hats up here. Of course, the Sellers clock. And we got some more hats. Old St. Louis Browns, and Indy 500, and then of course our entertainment center. All the stuff on there. So as you can see, I've decorated this room up. Right now this will change like four times a year. Actually, this racing, during the racing season, now here we have a picture of some people. Remember that one, Kev? A few years back there. But this here, during the racing season, see, actually, well, I'll give you the big picture first. This room will completely change four times a year. 3 months out of the year for each season. I'll have the racing season, the baseball season, the hockey season, and what I call the entertainment season. And those are the four times it'll change. But within each of those seasons, within the hockey season, and the racing season, these shirts will have to, I have too many shirts. They're not all out here right now. I've got another 30 or 40 racing shirts packed away. And those will be, I love this here speakerphone. These things are great. You don't even have to pick up the thing. See, you just dial your number, but it's kind of cool. But, and of course my magazines. You know, this is my little table where I sit and I got my slime there. And my book. I'm on a Marilyn Monroe kick right now, so getting some of her movies and reading the books. And so there's my weekly video and results from the Highland Speedway. I just got that today. I haven't had a chance to look at that yet or nothing. And we got some Hooters magazines and of course Playboys and Kathy Ireland there. It's a real guy's room, you know. But like I said, I still got about 30 shirts that are not up on this wall. A proud moment in my life right there indeed. I'm sure Kevin remembers that night very well. And, you know, we got more photos here up on the wall. And it's me announcing at Princeton. And it's Butch and Hammerly and Dennis, of course. Dennis again. And call Wickies. There's a Hooters sprint car. That was taken at Springfield, but nobody has any idea who the driver of it was. So, there's Terry Bridges pushing some guy at Springfield. So, you know, like I said, it's definitely a guy's room down here. You know, here I am driving the push car around the racetrack. I remember that. Had that blown up big size. But, you know, got a lot of guys type stuff hanging. This is a typical guy's room down here. You know, I relax and then have all of my knickknacks surrounding me, and I kind of like that. So, and then, of course, this is my dressing room, and I'm really happy with that. Because this is where I keep all of my clothes. And empty boxes that I need and things packed up in and whatnot. And my tools and things, and then my calendar so I can, you know, keep day by day of what I got coming up and getting all ready for the fair this year. I had to circle the two events we'll be going to. And there's my hat rack. Well, it's kind of a neat little room. That's where I get dressed and whatnot. Jan has the bedroom upstairs and I dress and whatnot down here. Now we got two rooms left. It's the downstairs bathroom. I'll just show it to you. Nothing real exciting about this. It's just a can. So, nothing real thrilling about that. Not too thrilled with the water pressure out of that shower. Can't seem to get it as hard as I'd like it to be, but so that's that. And the final room on the house, Cindy might want to leave the room for this next bit, because if you didn't like the way I've got this room out here decorated, you won't like the way I've got this next one decorated either. This is the den, computer, and what I like to call the Hooter room here. We have we have all kinds of things in this. This, of course, is where I'll be working on my book some more here at this computer terminal. Got all the knickknacks up there too and whatnot, and the printer and everything. But as you can see on the walls, we have more knickknacks and more Hooters stuff. My autographed picture from Lynn Austin, and I have a Hooters shirt, and then my big Alan Kulwicki poster. And then my little helmets. And here we have some pitchers. Now, this is a beer pitcher, which Kevin will enjoy thoroughly. Even the lamp gets into the act. See the lamp there? It's wearing a headband there. It likes that. And then here we have the mug that goes along with the pitcher, so that's always nice. And Lonnie should remember the Hooter Frisbees that we got that day at the Mall of America Hooters. license plate. And see, there's a mug and a Colwicky cap, Winston champion. And more Hooter stuff. Bought some of the sauce and batter from Florida, had it shipped up here. Had wings just last night, as a matter of fact. Had some Hooters wings. So that was kind of nice. And then, of course, as you remember, wait a minute, we got more Hooters stuff over here. Well, actually, some of this is racing and all kinds of stuff up on this wall here. And there's my Hooters scrapbook. And of course, you got your cabinets where I keep all my stuff. And then that's the same gal right there. She made the calendar this year, so she had her sign that picture. It says, how about me under the tree in 93, which... So, seriously, it does. That's what it says. Okay, and then, of course, we got cabinets over here and stuff, too. We got all my racing videos in those cabinets. And then, of course, I still do collect my Hot Wheel cars, and we got all them. Now, these aren't Hot Wheels here, but these are some NASCAR look-alike cars that I picked up. And there you have your scary guy there, and Steak and Shake, and all the Hot Wheel cars that I've collected over the years. Actually, most of these, in fact, none of these are from when I lived down there in the 60s and 70s, because those have all since been beaten up and tossed out. But this is my pride shelf here. I love all these old style looking things. So it's just a hobby, you know, something to occupy the time. So then this is my desk and just stuff like that. Of course, there's a Budweiser thing and you can look out into the yard. And where is that at? So that's pretty much it. That's pretty much our house. It's the grand tour. Hope you've enjoyed it, and hopefully you'll be coming up here to visit. And Kevin can sit and relax here in the Hooter room, and and Cindy's going, I don't think so.
Great pictures. Well, thank you. I guess the things I remember the most is what I consider the best is on when it reaches the final night of the year and the championship has not yet been decided. And that happened in 1969 when going into the final feature, Len Baumgartner beat Gene Dye by 50 points. It happened the next year in 1970 when it came down to that last feature between Koppel and Len Baumgartner. And then, of course, it happened here last year between Cordy, Faust, and Sellers. So every once in a while that happens, and those got to be the most exciting nights. But this past Monday night now, that was one of the most exciting races I've ever seen in my life. I mean, it was a great race, and I think it did so much and gives so much recognition to the type of racing and the great facility we have here at Highland Speedway. Oh, definitely, definitely. To get those big names like that out here and to have them put on a show like that, and then to have a local boy from right down the road come out and beat them, that was fantastic. Mark, tell us about the racing up in Minnesota. What do you do up there on the weekend? Well, the track I follow is the Princeton Speedway. That runs on Friday nights, and their top class is very, very similar to the IMCA modifieds that were out here Monday night with the invitational cars. They're called Wasota instead of IMCA, but it's the same thing. They're real restricted on engine size, tire size, all that kind of stuff. But they put on a real good show. Mark, how do you stay in contact with the Highland Speedway up in Minnesota? How do you keep in touch with the points and so forth? Well, a real great gentleman by the name of Dennis Tabor sends me those results every week, and I get a video from Gary Rubles, and between the two of them, I'm able to keep up real good. You actually get a tape every week up in Minnesota for races? Oh, yeah. I got quite a collection of tapes. Man, you must have a ton of tapes up there. How long have you been doing that, Mark? The tapes, since about 88. It's been great having you here tonight. Mark, you got your dad here tonight. He's filming us. I know you're going to stick around for a couple more days. You think about coming back down to the Highland area? Yeah, I'm trying. I tried it in 89, but I wasn't too well prepared at that time, so I decided to go back to school. I'm back in college now, and I got 1 year left, and then as soon as I'm out of that, I'll have my degrees behind me, and I'm going to try it again. Well, Mark, congratulations. Thanks for staying on top of all the great action here at Highland Speedway. Mark Jones, ladies and gentlemen, give a nice round of applause. Crystal, Minnesota. Thank you.
Todd!
Don't you wish you could have these cars? I believe we'll check that.